गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास अर्थ। नाउ अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोसीड हिस्ट्री चैप्टर टू। आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज द कार्नेटिक वॉर्स, दैट इज ऑलरेडी मेंशन्ड इन योर बुक ऑन पेज नंबर 12। कार्नेटिक वॉर्स, there are three carnatic wars which had been fought between the French East India Company and the British East India Company. So we are going to discuss about all these three carnatic wars sequently. The first carnatic war, which was started in 1744 and lasted till 1748 between the British East India Company and the French East India Company. The second Carnatic War again started in 1748 and lasted till 1754. This war also fought between the French East India Company and the British East India Company, in which the French were defeated. And the third Carnatic War, which was started in 1756 and lasted till 1763, this war had been also fought between the French and British East India Company. In this war, French were also defeated again by the British in 1760s at the battle of Vandivo, the French capital of Pondicherry fell to the British in 1761, and like this the Carnatic Wars had been over. Thereafter, motive of the mercantile trading companies. The word mercantile used for an enterprise that makes money, profit, benefit through trade, buying goods at cheaper rates and selling them at higher rates. Mercantile means it is a word that is used for an enterprise which makes the benefit, which makes the profit, which makes the money by trading. By trading means buying goods at cheaper rates and sold those goods at higher rates. The European companies and merchants came to India basically for trading. First of all, primarily, British did not come to India to rule over here. Their motives is only trade. Gradually, they controlled the political power by controlling the revenues of the state. But whatever the situations had changed and they got interested in Indian politics. Gradually, they got control. The political powers by controlling revenue of states. Due to industrialization, European countries need for the markets and colony arose. Thus, the primary motives of the European trading companies was money and power. They have needed, after industrialization, the markets, the colonies, so that they gain money from India through business, through trade, and they also got power, while knowledge, data, technique as secondary motives. Thereafter, British policies of expansion. There are several policies to expand the territory in them. The first one is the policy of direct conquest. In this, they directly conquered the areas, fought battles and wars, got victory and also got control over that area. Policy of subsidiary alliance. This was started by the Governor General Lord Wellesley. Through this method, any Indian state could use British Army for their protection. Any Indian state any Indian state would be eligible to got protection through British Army, and Indian ruler had to make payments for this, and for that the Indian rulers who sought help from the British Army protection, he had to pay their payments. In case of failure of payment, the British officials called resident, and in case the ruler was not able to pay their payments, then those army members would be the resident of that territory. And got control over a part of their territory as penalty. The resident was creating hindrance in the court decisions of the rulers, and those who were being the resident, they were create the hindrances, the disturbances in the court decision of those rulers. Thereafter, doctrine of lapse. This was introduced by the Governor General Lord Dalhousie, who was being the Governor General of India from 1848 to 1856. The doctrine declared that if an Indian ruler died without a male heir, means if any ruler who was childless, his kingdom would lapse, that is, became part of the company territory. In that case, his kingdom came under the control of Britishers. Like this, Satara, Sambalpur, Udaipur, Nagpur and Jhansi were annexed simply applying this doctrine. After this, we have to discuss about Battle of Plassey in next video. Thank you.